Welcome, dear students, to yet another lecture on the history of English language and literature. We are discussing the first unit, the first module of our syllabus, and so far we have discussed some of the socio-political situation of the Victorian era. We gave a general introduction to the Victorian era. Then we discussed about the Reform Acts, the first Reform Act of 1832. And the subsequent Reform Acts of 1867 and 1884. The social changes that were brought about in England due to these Reformation Acts were discussed. Then we talked about the industrialization and the impact of industrialization on the Victorian society. We talked about the rise of Oxford and Cambridge universities. We discussed the spread of science and technology and the impact of the spread of science and technology on the Victorian society. Then we had a short discussion on some of the important personalities of the period. We discussed Charles Darwin and his theory of evolution. We talked about Karl Marx and his theory of Marxism. We discussed John Stuart Mill and the theory of utilitarianism. We talked about Sigmund Freud and the theory of psychoanalysis. And lastly, we also discussed India and the great British Empire, how India became a colony of the British Empire. There are many more things that we can say about the socio-political situation of the Victorian era, but our syllabus requires only the above mentioned topics. My dear students, from this lecture onwards, we are going to discuss about the literary history of the Victorian period, the literary history of the Victorian period. And please remember that both the socio-political history as well as the literary history are very important. But from the examination point of view, looking at the question papers of the previous years, very often the literary history is more important than the social-political history from the point of view of the examinations. And today, we shall begin our discussion of the Victorian novel. The Victorian novel. The Victorian period was considered as the golden age of the novel. The golden age of the novel. Now, novel was the most dominating literary form of the age. The novel became the most popular genre in the Victorian era. Then the novel was easier to be read and understood by simple people. The novel was not so very complicated like poetry or drama or any other literary genre. It was very simple to be read and easy to be understood. So that was the popularity of the novel, simple to be read and easy to be understood. The novel was a kind of mirror. The novel was a kind of mirror which reflected the society. And it was possible for the readers to identify themselves in the novel. The characters and the plots were the reflection of the society, and the readers could easily identify themselves in the novel. It was also the main form of entertainment for the educated middle class. It was also the main form of entertainment for the educated middle classes. Now, the middle class women, they were the most keen or the most interested readers of the novels. The middle class women had plenty of wealth. They had plenty of free time and also had a lot of privacy to read. So, the middle class women used to read the novels very often. And the novels were published in installments, part by part. This would increase or this would improve the reading public. The novels were published in installments. Every week, a few pages of the novels were included in some important periodicals. So it was given in installments so people could read it. My dear students, let us see something general about the Victorian novelists. This you must remember. The novelists represented the society as they saw it. Please remember this, the novelist represented the society. They tried to present the reality as it was, as they saw it. The novels reflected the social evils of the society. The social evils of the times were portrayed in the novel, and this would stimulate people to find some solutions for the evils of the society. Thus, the novels had an educating element, or in other words, didacticism was the dominating aim of most of the novels. The novels reflected society, it had a didactic element. Though several authors tried to give a comprehensive picture of the contemporary society, comprehensive means all inclusive or complete picture of the society, but in general, the tendency was towards specialization. Please remember this, the tendency of the novelists were for specialization. One characteristic of the Victorian novelists that we need to keep in mind is that each novelist would specialize in certain areas. Thus we see the novels of the sea, one specialization, the novels of the military life, the novels of high life, the novels of law life, the novels of industrial life, and so on. So a lot of specialization in novels. There were novels of specialization during this time. Please remember this particular point. The novels of this time had some kind of specialization, not general themes. One of the most popular genre or most popular types of novels that was existing at that time was Bill Dung's romance. Now this particular novel, this genre, traced the life of the protagonist from infancy to early adulthood. The Bildung's Roman novels dealt with one person's formative years or spiritual education. So, Bildung's Roman. The novelists of the Victorian period felt a social and moral responsibility to portray society in a realistic way, to denounce or criticize the injustices of the society, and they also expressed their faith in progress as well. Very often the plots of the novels were very long and very, very complicated by many subplots. So these are some of the characteristics of the Victorian novels. Dear students, having discussed some little introduction or having given some introduction about the Victorian novels, now we shall talk about the early Victorian novelists, some women writers and some late Victorian novelists. Early Victorian novelists, women writers and some late Victorian novelists. Let's talk about some of the early Victorian novelists. Now, the early Victorian novelists were born in the first half of the 19th century. So, they were born in the first half of the 19th century. Some common characteristics exhibited by the early Victorian novelists were that the early Victorian novelists were aware of their moral and social responsibility. They were aware of their moral and social responsibility. So they described the social changes. They were aware of the evils of the society and always denounced them. The most popular or the most representative of the early Victorian novelist is Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens. He would describe different social classes and their professions, different conditions of life, and even the most miserable ones of the society. We will discuss more about Charles Dickens in the coming lectures. Another important early Victorian is William Makepeace Thackeray. William Makepeace Thackeray. Now, while Charles Dickens described the miserable ones of the society, Thackeray described more the world of the upper class. The world of the upper class. Though he described the upper class more, he was critical of their lack of morality, their lack of morals. He was critical of a society based on money and appearances. So Victorian society was based on money and appearances. The rich class, he would depict them. Thus, the two most outstanding novelists of the early Victorian period were Charles Dickens and William Thackeray. Now let us see something about the women writers of the time. So during the Victorian era, the women were considered as angel in the home. Women is considered as angel in the home. They were educated to become good wives and were never sent to the university. they were responsible for the education of the children. And many middle and upper class women, they were great readers, and some of them were good writers as well. So there is something about the women of the Victorian era. We shall see some of them. Charlotte and Emily Bronte, they were two women writers who wrote novels of romantic love. They wrote about novels of romantic love. Elizabeth Gaskell was interested in the condition of the working class people and of the fallen women. Fallen women like unmarried mothers, prostitutes, etc. And the third woman writer is George Eliot. Her name was Mary Ann Evans. She adopted a male pseudonym as George Eliot as a writer. She described in detail the rural life of the provinces, and she expressed deep psychological insight into her character's mind. So these are the important female writers of the time, women writers of the time. Now let us talk about the late Victorian novelists. The novelist of the second half, the novelist of the second half of the 19th century is known as the late Victorian novelists. They no more identified with the values of the society and openly criticized them, but they were much influenced by Charles Darwin and his theory of evolution, and also they were influenced by the theory of positivism. Now we have learned about the theory of evolution and Charles Darwin. Now what is positivism? Positivism will accept only that which can be verified scientifically. There are many things that cannot be verified scientifically. Positivism does not accept that. There are many things like metaphysics, life after death. These things cannot be verified. That which cannot be verified is not accepted by positivists. Such notions cannot be verified scientifically. The late Victorian novelists were guided by positivism and the theory of evolution. The important novelists of the late Victorian period were Thomas Hardy, who was a pessimist, who had a pessimistic view of the world. Then Henry James, who was an American by birth, and he showed the conflict between the American and European culture. Lewis Carroll, who authored children's works and created the genre of nonsense literature. And we have Oscar Wilde, who was the main representative of aestheticism. So you will ask, what is aestheticism? Aestheticism considered art as completely detached from any morals. So there was no didactic element, or there was no didactic purpose for art. It had only mainly aesthetic purpose. So dear students, we are coming to the end of this lecture, and we have just introduced the Victorian novelists. In the next classes, we will discuss three important Victorian novelists: Charles Dickens, George Eliot, and Thomas Hardy. For your assignment, please write a short paragraph introducing the Victorian novel and some of the general characteristics of the Victorian novel, and also mention the important Victorian novelists, the early Victorian novelists, some women writers, as well as the late Victorian novelists. Thank you for your patient listening. Hope to meet you again soon with the lectures on Victorian novels. Have a nice time.